In this video, I will demonstrate you that how you can control the speed of a three-phase induction motor with the help of PIC 1816 IC, which is connected to a LCD display to check the different parameters of the controller. And there are basically two ways to control the speed of the motor. So as you can see over here, I have a PIC 1.6, which is connected with the LCD display, and there are basically two resistors. One is acting as a variable resistor to control the speed of the motor, and the second one is acting as a feedback sensor, so which can be any sensor like speed sensor, or you can connect any kinds of sensor there with which you want to control its PID values. So the circuit is basically based on a PID value. So on the right side, you can see that there are basically three pulses which is coming out from the PIC IC, and these three pulses will be then delivered to a three identical circuits, which are basically IR2110 circuits, which are basically acting as a driver circuits for a hexa bridge base IGBTs or MOSFET circuit. So over here you can see this is a hexa bridge circuit, which is have basically proper protection for each IGBT as well. So after that, you can see I have connected a oscilloscope, and then there is an induction motor as well, which is connected in star position. So you can see this one is basically the star point, and these three are the phases. So over here is the DC supply which will be given to the circuit. This is the ground circuits, and now let's run the simulation. On the oscilloscope, you will see basically three different parameters. One is the set value, which is the value that we will be controlling from here. The second is the feedback value, and the third one is the PID value, which will be given by the controller to make sure that the set value and the present values are exactly same. So let's run the simulation. So as you can see over here, as you run the simulation, it is saying that please wait, it will take a little bit of time. So you can see that it's PIC based three phase VFD, so it will take a little bit of more time to display the values. But as you can see on the right side, the pulses are started, so the feedback value will be received after a little bit of time, so that the controller and the motor are in running position. We are basically measuring the output as like an RPMs, so you can also use any other parameters. As you can see, the set value, which is 1574 RPM, the present value, that is also 1574 RPM, the feedback, which is basically implemented after subtracting the present value and the set value. So let me show you the motor running. So this is the motor. As you can see, this is basically slowly increasing its RPM to its maximum value. So this is how the complete circuit is working. These are basically the pulses. You might think these are basically two compressors. You can also expand them from here as well. So this is basically the space vector pulse width modulation topology, which will give you a pure and proper control over the motor. We have also developed the hardware for this design as well. So in case if you are interested in getting the hardware, you can also send a mail. And in case if you are interested in getting those files like this schematic file, code and programming files along with the PCB files, you can send a mail on my mail ID. I will also give a link in the description as well. Thank you guys for watching. Have a great day.